Hi everybody, this is Paul Day, professor of geology and environmental sciences. I am hiking around up here in Oregon and visiting a place called the Newberry Caldera and caught wind of the fact that there might be some pretty interesting geological features associated with volcanism in the Cascades. So I decided to come and check it out to look at a phenomenon known as lava casts. This is a phenomenon that occurs when trees are hit by hot lava. The hot lava effectively destroys the tree, but the tree quenches and cools the lava and creates a cast of itself surrounding it, and it leaves a remnant of itself in the lava. So I'm actually hiking around here looking at a lava flow. Let's see if we can get a look at it. It's this lava flow right here that we're looking at. We could tell by the rubbly material up on top, this is something called an ah-ah flow. Ah-ah being an onomatopoeia Hawaiian word for the sound that you make when you walk across it, right? Ah-ah. This is a really craggly material, very broken up. The geologist would use the term brecciated frequently to describe this. So we are hiking down this trail here, and apparently there's some good molds, or I'm sorry, casts of trees in this lava flow. So let's see what we can find. So hiking around up here, we're looking for these molds, but we also see some pretty cool features associated with lava flows. This is a little lava tube that is collapsed. You can hear all the broken material under my feet. And underneath there, let's see if we can get the camera down under there. You can see the drip features from where the lava was dripping off the top of this thing when it was still hot material flowing under here and coming down. In fact, here's a drip stone right there. It's upside down, but this is what the bottom of that lava tube would have looked like. Again, it's not very big, it's not a large one, but lava tubes help lava flow long distances because it insulates the material underneath and allows it to go. All right. And sure enough, it didn't take very long. The rumors are true. Of course they're true because I heard it from some reliable sources. There are, in fact, lava trees here. And we see one located right here. Well, it doesn't look like a tree. But again, it's a cast. The lava is going to come in, and this is what used to be a trunk of a tree right here. And the lava would have come this direction and piled up. We can see it's piled up on one side of this thing. Piled up here and then gone around it while the tree was in the middle there, cooling and quenching the lava and leaving a cast of itself. It turns out there's actually several of these in the area. A few feet away from the one we just showed you, is this much deeper tree. And it shows kind of how thick this lava flow originally was, right? It's probably about 6 feet deep. That's about how deep this hole is. And hiking around this area has revealed that this is an area completely filled with these types of trees. So it isn't just a few, there's dozens and dozens of them out here in this volcanic field at the Newberry Caldera in Oregon. Anyways, thanks for checking in with us and checking out lava casts. Take care.